Hi, it's Bob Berryhill of Surfaris. I'm here with the Surf Channel. We're going to surf ourselves right into the sunset. The Surfaris have never left the scene. It's always kind of like Paul McCartney said, you go in and out of style. So basically, I've been performing since I was 8 years old. The band formed in 1963 when I was 15 years old, and I have been playing consistently all of these years. So that's 53 years, I believe. The band with my family started in the year 2000. My two sons joined the band, and my wife also joined the band as the bass player. We've been working together now for 17 years together, so we pretty much know all the songs by heart. I started surfing back in 1960 in Hawaii at Waikiki Beach. Had one of the original Beach Boys, not the band, but original Beach Boys, teach me how to surf. So I started surfing when I was 13, and I've continued to surf ever since. And I surf right now at Laguna Beach. Surfing and surf music are intertwined because of the greatness of the driving music that we play. The intertwining of surf music with the surf culture and surf boards and surf clothes all started in about 1958-59 when the people would come off of the beach, they wanted to dance, and they had to dance to fast music, and surf music is instrumental, and we didn't have big fancy PA systems, and so surf music became the surf music of the day, and the music was hard and fast, and we had like 400 people in the audience and they wanted to dance. So it was a natural occurrence that happened after you surfed. You wanted to dance like you were still surfing. The motivation behind the music of the Surfaris is that we were surfers and we would come down to the beach and listen to other bands play the music, and we went home and said, you know, we could do this better. And so we got Leo Fender with the Fender guitars and the Fender amps, and we started playing hard and strong in our garage. It's what they call the garage band, right? But it was not termed then that. But we basically took the feeling of surf and surf music and kind of blended it together. The iconic nature of Wipeout is a cultural need for identification. And Wipeout, when you're surfing and you wipe out, you know how bad that is to hit the bottom, especially in Waikiki or any of the big waves like off of Haleiwa or the Big Island. Because what happens is you hit one of those coral reefs, you're gonna be really wiping out hard. And so Wipeout is that sort of a generic term that can be used for motorcycle wiping out, crashes of all sorts. And so the iconic part of it is part of the culture that allows itself to feel like they're energetic, like they're gonna do something with themselves. Well, we're on the 3 Days of Waves show tour, and the show we did last night was awesome. It was a club down in Sunset Beach. And the night before that, we were in Del Mar down San Diego way. It went great. We're playing the music the way 1963 sounded. Like I say, because we all had dancers out there, they loved to dance to our music. So tonight we're gonna be playing complete songs, not just little snippets that you hear in commercials and elevators. As far as touring for our band, I guess you'd have to say we're seasonal, because people love to hear surf music in the summertime. And we do some Christmas shows sometimes. But basically what we do is we try to pick and choose the events that make the most sense for our music. And people are coming out of the woodwork because they want to hear the actual music by the actual guy who wrote it and played it. And that's what we're doing. We're kind of finding venues that fit our music, like for instance where we're playing tonight here in Malibu. They really want the people who live in this area to hear what surf music really sounds like. Hi, it's Bob Berryhill of the Surfaris of Wipeout Surfer Joe fame. You're watching the Surf Channel.